Hello friends, I am Vinod Kumar Garg, working as professor in the Department of Environmental Science and Technology, Central University of Punjab. Today in this lecture, we are going to discuss different digital initiatives taken by Government of India in the higher education. We all know that knowledge is power. The era has gone when the weapons and armies were considered as power. Nowadays, knowledge is power, and you know that the knowledge is most costly commodity. And I'm of the firm belief that the knowledge can be enhanced or knowledge can be gained making the use of information and communication technologies. So in this module, we will be discussing about different initiatives taken by Government of India. Before starting different initiatives, we must know, or most of you might be knowing, that in 2009, Government of India approved National Mission on Education through Information and Communication Technology, and the same was launched on 3rd February 2009 as a centrally sponsored scheme. Basically, this National Mission on Education through Information and Communication Technology was based on three cardinals of education, and these three cardinals of education are access, equity, and quality. Means the basic idea was that information should go, or the knowledge should reach to the last person sitting in the last corner of the country. Equity means it should be available to all, and quality means the content, whatever is developed under this mission, should be developed by the experts and should be of good quality. So the mission has two major components. One component is to provide the connectivity, this internet connectivity, along with provision for access devices. That may be computer, that may be laptop, that may be mobile phone, etc., to institutions and learners. And second component is the content generation. So this all idea came in 2009, and now we are at a stage where a number of digital initiatives have been taken in higher education by the Government of India. So with this background, in this lecture, we shall be discussing about EPG Pathshala program, MOOCs, and Swayam portal. The full form of Swayam is Study Web of Active Learning by Young and Aspiring Minds. And third digital initiative that is based on the satellite technology, that is Swayam Prabha program, will also be discussed. Let me start with EPG Pathshala program. EPG Pathshala is an initiative of Ministry of Human Resource and Development under its National Mission on Education through ICT that we have discussed just now, being executed by the University Grants Commission, New Delhi. EPG Pathshala program is a gateway to 77 non-technical PG courses across different disciplines, including social sciences, arts, fine arts, and humanities, natural and mathematical sciences, linguistics, and languages. The website of EPG Pathshala is epgp.inflibnet.ac.in. In EPG Pathshala, as I told earlier, the content has been developed for 77 subjects. Let me have an idea about the content. In each subject, whole syllabus has been divided into 16 papers, means 4 papers per semester, because in all PG courses, the PG courses are 4 semesters program. And each paper contains 30 to 40 modules. So each subject will be having somewhere from 500 to 600 modules. In developing these modules, 4-quadrant approach has been used. Means each lecture, for a lecture, the word module has been used here. Each module is having four components, and these components are called as quadrants. The first quadrant is e-text, that is text material of 10 to 12 pages, about of 3000 words. The second is the self-learning quadrant. Self-learning quadrant is a video. The video has been prepared by the experts. The video is of say about 25 to 30 minutes. Third quadrant is self-assessment. Once you have read the text material, you have seen the video, then you can assess yourself that how much knowledge has been gained by this. So in the self-assessment, there are some MCQs, true, false, small answer questions, etc., etc., etc. For each module, there are 10 to 20 questions. And fourth quadrant is learn more. If you are interested to enhance further knowledge on this topic, then in the learn more quadrant, information about different books, different websites, and other related materials is given. This diagram shows that how the content has been developed under APG Pathshala program. For each subject, there is one principal investigator. This principal investigator appoints or nominates 16 paper coordinators, means one paper coordinator for one paper. Then, as each paper is having 30 to 40 modules, then the team of module writers or content writers is identified by the paper coordinator with the help of principal coordinator and other paper coordinators. Now, to make it a quality content, for each paper there is a language editor also. So language editor will improve, and then there is a technical expert also for the video correction, etc. So like this, this is a big team of experts that has developed this material. Let we have the live demonstration of EPG Pathshala. Let we have a tour of the EPG Pathshala web page. Open Google, and in Google type EPG Pathshala. So this the first website that will appear is of EPG Pathshala in Flipnet. Just click this website, and this is the page of EPG Pathshala. This portal of EPG Pathshala is managed by the InfliBNet Gandhinagar. Now, to search the content on EPG Pathshala web page, open Student Corner. In Student Corner, you will find the uploaded content. Uploaded content is available here in two forms: e-content, four quadrant, and e-content static. E-content 4 quadrant means all the 4 quadrant of that particular module are available on the website, whereas e-content static means 2-3 modules are available and some module is missing, that may be video, that may be learn more, or that may be questions, etc. So as far as this e-content 4 quadrant is concerned, about 23,000 modules of different subjects are already uploaded on the website. Similarly, about 23,000 modules of e-content static are uploaded on the website of EPG Pathshala. Now let us see one or two subjects. Let me start with my own subject. My subject is environmental sciences. Let you click here in the four quadrant, environmental sciences. On the left hand side, you will find the information about the team that has developed these four quadrants. PI for this EPG Pathshala environmental sciences is Professor R.K. Kohli, who is Vice Chancellor of Central University of Punjab. In this environmental sciences subject, 16 papers have been developed, and static content has been developed for 521 modules, and 279 videos are already uploaded. Let us visit any one paper. Let we visit paper number 11, that is Solid and Hazardous Waste Management. So here, if you click here, the list of all modules for which material has been uploaded will appear. Let us see any one module. Whatever module you want to see, click that module. Once you click that module, this page will open. Here you will find that e-text is uploaded, self-learning, that is video, is uploaded, and learn more means the information about other sources is also uploaded. So this page will open. From here, the text of this module can be downloaded. Yes, so here we have downloaded this module, and this downloaded text you can use for your academic or educational purposes. If you are interested to see the video, then click on the self-learning. So this page will open. Just click here and the video will start. Let us see some other subject from the humanities. Again, we have to go to the student corner. Again, list will appear, and let we click this Sanskrit. In Sanskrit, let us see this paper number 9, Vyakaran. 640 modules have been prepared for this paper, and here the list will appear. Let us see this module number 7, that is concept of Karaka. So again, by clicking here, you can download the text material, and by clicking self-learning, the video will start. Friends, we have seen that huge material, huge educational material has been developed for 77 subjects, and the same has been uploaded on the website of EPG Pathshala, that is managed by InfliBNet. I'll request you to please tell your students, and please ask your colleagues, and you yourself use this EPG Pathshala portal and use this material and these videos for your lectures or to educate your students. Second digital initiative taken by Government of India is MOOCs. The full form of MOOCs is Massive Open Online Courses. Let me discuss about MOOC. The meaning of massive is large enrollment number. Open means no mandatory qualification, open to all. Online means fully online. Course means structured course content. So this is a online course aimed at unlimited participation and open access via the web. The basic philosophy of MOOCs is 3A, means anyone, anytime, anywhere. Now a question arises that how MOOC is different from the EPG Pathshala program. Actually, in case of EPG Pathshala, e-content has been developed and uploaded on the website. Means EPG Pathshala is a open education resource. Anybody can download that material. If some query arises in your mind, if some questions come to your mind, nobody is there to answer your query or your question. Means there is no hand holding by the teacher of the student. Whereas in case of MOOC, there is e-content, there is a video, there is a lecture like EPG Pathshala, but there is a teacher or there is a faculty member or there is a facilitator to guide you. Means there is hand holding in MOOC of the student or learner by some teacher or by some facilitator. In case of MOOC, if some query arises in your mind, somebody is there to answer that query. Further, in case of MOOC, there is a provision of credit transfer, that is not in case of EPG Pathshala. And in case of MOOC, at the end, we will have a properly proctored exam and the credits can be transferred from one institution to the other institution in case of MOOC. How the MOOCs are developed? There are two methods which are at presently used for the development of MOOC. One is the repurposing of the EPG Pathshala content. In this case, the material that has been developed in the EPG Pathshala, that is converted into or repurposed into MOOC. And second method is new MOOCs to be developed. Nowadays, emphasis has been given on the development of new MOOCs. So, and this MOOC programs are hosted or available at the Swayam portal. Swayam portal is taken care by this several agencies, and one of them is AICT. On 19th July 2016, Government of India promulgated UGC credit framework for online learning courses through Swayam regulations 2016. In this regulation, provisions have been given that if a student is doing a course from X institute, the credit from X institute will be transferred to the in that institute where the student is studying. So let us see some of the provisions that are given in this gazette notification regarding the MOOCs and Swayam. The online learning courses shall be made available on the Swayam platform by the PI identified by the national MOOC coordinators. Means MOOC courses will be available on the Swayam platform, and these will be through the host institution as per the schedule finalized by him or her. Another very important provision is that an institution can allow only up to 20% of the total courses being offered in a particular program in a semester through the online learning courses provided through Swayam platform. Means suppose there are four courses in a semester, then only one course can be done through Swayam portal, not all the courses through the Swayam portal. The parent institution where the student is studying shall give the equivalent credit weightage to the student for the credits earned through online learning courses through Swayam platform in the credit plan of that particular program. No university shall refuse any student for the credits earned through the MOOCs. Now, what is the procedure that to be adopted by universities for adopting MOOCs on Swayam? For that, universities should make amendments in their ordinances to adopt MOOCs. Universities select the courses to be permitted for credit transfer through Swayam. Each university designate a course coordinator to guide the students. University disseminate information about selected courses to the student. University to facilitate registration of students. The host institution shall evaluate the student, host institution where the course has been offered. So that institution shall evaluate the students registered for MOOC courses. The university shall incorporate the marks or grades communicated by the host institution in the final mark sheet of the student and no university shall refuse any student for credit mobility for courses earned through MOOCs. Now, what is the outcome of this MOOC project? This addresses the problem of access, equity and quality by addressing faculty shortage and lack of good quality faculty. The project would help the students and teachers to update their knowledge and skills, especially for those located in rural, backward or remote areas. The project would successfully bridge the digital divide and would help the nation move toward information-rich society. Let me take a live tour of Swayam portal. Just type here Swayam and open this first website. The website of Swayam portal is swayam.gov.in. This site will open. Yes. So this is the Swayam site. If you are a student, you can register here. And after registering, if you have to log in, then you can log in here. Then here information about all courses are given. That on Swayam, two type of courses are there. One are the scheduled courses, structured courses, and the self-paced courses. Basically, these scheduled courses, these are for the students. Means once these are offered in the month of July and August, and second time they are offered in the month of January. Two times these are offered. In case of structured courses, there is a defined syllabus, as well as there is a defined number of credits. There will be exam, assignment, quizzes, etc. for this. And at the end of this course, student has to appear in the exam. Exam of the student will be in that particular institute where the student is presently studying. Student is not supposed to move to the host institute for the exam. And so after exam, paper will be evaluated by the course coordinator and marks will be given to the controller of examination of the host institution, and controller of examination of the host institution will transfer the credits or the marks earned by the student to the institute of the student. When you apply for a MOOC course, what you require? First, you must have a structured syllabus with you. You must be very clear that this course will be of 2 credits, 3 credits or 4 credits. And in addition to that, you have to make a small video of 4-5 minutes about that course. Upload that video on the YouTube and then give link on the Swayam portal. So when you apply for the course, you have to give the means introduction of the course, its structure, that is the course syllabus, lecture plan, and a video. And then your idea will be evaluated by the National Advisory Committee on MOOC, and if your idea is good, you will be sanctioned the MOOC course. Many a times this question is asked, that why do I develop this MOOC? What benefit I am going to draw out of this? Dear friends, let me tell you one thing. World is changing very fast. 10 years down the line, a teacher will not be a teacher, a teacher will be a content developer. Technology is changing very fast. I am of firm belief that after 10 years, books will not be there. All the educational material will be available on the internet. So when you develop a MOOC of 4 credits, a grant of 13.5 lakhs rupees is given to you by the University Grant Commission. And in that, there is remuneration for content writing, there is remuneration for recording, video development, review, etc. And once material is developed, and suppose you are running a course on MOOC for a semester, that time you are given an honorarium of rupees 2 lakh rupees for once running this course for one semester. If you rerun this course, that time you are again given the honorarium about rupees 1.5 lakh by the UGC. In addition to that, there is a provision of API score in the new guidelines for the MOOC course. So I hope that you will tell your students about Swayam Portal, guide them to register for MOOC courses. You will motivate them to register for these MOOC courses and do these MOOC courses. In addition to that, I hope you will apply for MOOC courses to the UGC on Swayam Portal. One thing more I would like to mention here, that there is no time for the MOOC courses, means this is a rolling advertisement. Anytime you can apply for a MOOC course. Some jingles have been developed for MOOC courses and these are available on the website of Swayam Portal. Please show these jingles to your students also. The third digital initiative that we will discuss or that we will talk is Swayam Prabha. In case of Swayam Prabha, basically this is use of DTH channels. This is use of satellite technology for taking high quality education to the masses. 32 DTH channels devoted to telecasting of high quality educational programs on 24/7 basis using the GSAT 15 satellite. In each channel, at present, 4 hours of fresh content every day is provided and that is repeated 5 times to facilitate viewing as per convenience. If at any particular time you cannot see the content, at some other time you can see that content. The idea is to increase this time from four hours content to 6 hours content in the future. The contents which are shown in these 32 DTH channels are curriculum based at graduate and postgraduate levels, covered in very structured manner. The lectures which are available on the Swayam Prabha are by the best teachers from premier institutions in the country, and these cover all disciplines, engineering science, humanities, commerce, etc. 4 IIT PEL channels are also there on Swayam Prabha in mathematics, physics, chemistry and biology to assist class 12 and 11th student preparing for competitive exam like IIT, JEE, medical, etc. So what are the objectives of Swayam Prabha? Swayam Prabha is a satellite technology and this is available on the television. So its objectives include equal access, school education, live classes, higher education, curriculum based courses and competitive exam partners. Such a big thing cannot be done by one organization. There are several partners in the Swayam Prabha project. Let us see who are the partners in the Swayam Prabha project. One is BISEC. This is Messrs. Electronic Corporation of India Limited, ECIL, and Bhaskaracharya Institute for Space Application and Geoinformatics, that is BISAG, set up the uplinking station at BISAG. Then InfliBNet is for portal for program schedule and video archival. Then Department of Space. Department of Space allocated 2 transponders in GSAT 15 and content is developed by NEPTEL, IITs, UGC, CEC, IGNU, NCRT and National Institute of Open Schooling. These channels have been distributed among different organizations. 10 channels have been given to UGC, CEC. And these 10 channels that are allocated to UGC CEC are for non-technology UGPG program. NEPTEL has also been allocated 10 channels and these channels are for engineering science and technology. IGNU has been given 4 channels and these are for diploma courses. IIT PEL is also given 4 channels, and as we discussed earlier, these are for competitive exam preparation. NCERT is given 1 channel, and that is for school education, and National Institute of Open Schooling has been provided 3 channel, and these are for open education. There is a website of Swayamprabha. Friends, I will request you to please visit the website of Swayamprabha and tell your students and other colleagues about Swayamprabha channels. If possible, try to have these DTH channels. These are free to air in your college or in your university. So more and more people come to know about this Swayamprabha satellite technology. So to summarize this lecture, in this lecture we have learnt about different digital initiatives taken by Government of India. First, we discussed the EPG Pathshala. We all know EPG Pathshala program is for 77 subjects and taken care by UGC, and the website is managed by InfliBNet of EPG Pathshala, and more than 23,000 quality modules are available on its website. Second one is MOOC. We tried to find out the difference in EPG Pathshala and MOOC. In case of MOOC, we discussed 2 major issues, that how a student can opt for a MOOC, and secondly, how a faculty can develop a MOOC, and we also discussed that what benefits a faculty is going to get from developing of a MOOC. And third, we discussed the Swayamprabha satellite channel technology. The Swayamprabha is managed by Government of India, MHRD, and there are 32 channels. Different organizations have been given different channels to run the material. Every day, 4 hours, new content is given by each channel. And in the end, I will again say, knowledge is power, and attain this power through information and communication technology. Thank you.